Alright guys, welcome to another video. It's going to be more of the same shit, different day sort of situation. Got some more exhaust work to do. Start the video with this project here. Picked this up from RPM. I actually went down and picked this up last night. And driving it back at like 8 o'clock was so sketch because like the headlights kept shutting off. None of the gauges work, so I don't even know how much gas is in it. There's really like no exhaust hooked up on it, so it was just like loud and sketch, and it doesn't ride very good. I don't even know if this thing has tags on it either, but yeah, it was just kind of all bad. So I'm gonna get this thing racked. Don't know exactly what I'm doing, but I'm gonna get it up and find out. This thing's got Cook's headers and a high flow cat Cook's Y pipe on it, and then it just ends right there. And then there's the rest of this exhaust. This is kind of like, what the fuck? So what the fuck is that? Anywho, so I got this, which should match that, but what the hell? There's no other piece. So I'm gonna have to cut that off. That's great. And take it off. Cause I have this one, but it's supposed to have one of these on there. Okay, so I'll have to cut it off and weld this one on, and that'll go on there like that. So I guess step one, take that shit out. Alright, now I got that thing pulled out, just threw a new blade on my bandsaw, because that one had been on there forever and it had a couple bends in it, so it was kind of sketchy, but yeah, throw that up there and cut that guy off there now. So got that flange tacked on there, made sure my 2-bolt flange was on there before I did this. Capped this end with tin foil, got my back purge line in, got that capped. So right now it's just filling up, and I'm gonna give it a minute and then I'm gonna start welding it. Not the prettiest weld in the world, but it'll work. I think this might be 400 series stainless because it welded really weird, but yeah, now I can throw this piece back up in the truck and it won't have to come out again, and then I'll bolt this guy onto the back of there and then build back and tie in with the rest of what's there. All right, so I got that center section there tacked in. That's gonna be a sucky weld because that's aluminized, but I'm gonna pull it out and back purge it anyways, and then I just got those two welds, throw it back up in there, and tighten the shit out of that, and it's good to go. Well, that stuff welded super gross. Fuck aluminized. That weld up there was kind of meh. I don't think Cook's uses very good material for their stuff. Not 100% sure. It might just be me, but even like the Y-pipe didn't weld that nice, and that was all of like that material. So yeah, so now I'm just gonna stab this up in the truck. I gotta plug in the O2 sensors and put the retainers on the catalytic converter bolts, and should be done with this thing and maybe go deliver it to them today, even though I really don't want to drive this thing, but I really don't want it sitting here either. So yep, almost done. So that's that. That was pretty simple. Took me like an hour and a half to do. That tip drives me fucking bonkers though, man. It's so ugly. But yeah, so I'm going to take this thing down and probably run it down to him right now. Dead battery. Alright, be back in a little while. This is what I'm doing on the Speedster. You guys haven't seen this thing in a while, I don't think. So I ended up having to cut the rear of the body. I think I did put that in a video, and had to reshape it and put a peak on it. So then put the body back on the chassis, mounted the parking brake, had to modify the shifter, and mock fit the pedals. So just kind of templating out a firewall and a floor pan for this thing. I already have like a floor structure tacked in under there. So right now I'm just basically templating to see if I can make the shapes, if it looks good, if it leaves enough room for everything. And I'm about 3 hours now, 4 hours into this today. I just had the firewall when I started, so made pretty good progress on this. It was kind of a trick measuring how the parking brake goes because it's at an angle, but got it pretty good. Might try fucking around doing something in there right now, but we'll see. It's getting kind of late. I might just head home. This is why I don't weld it into the base plates first, so I can move the cage around and get to all the spots I need to get to, like the top of the A-pillar there. I'll barely be able to get in there and do that. And the top of the windshield bar, this one's gonna be a bit easier. But then once I have those welded in, then I can weld it into the base plates because everything else is done. The door bars, the swept gussets, I like everything else, so I'm gonna do that now. So everything's welded on you know, this portion of the cage. It's all 360 welded all the way around, even on the very top. So now it's resting on the base plates, kind of where I like it. The other reason I do this too is because if you had those fully welded into the base plates and then you welded everything else in, it would actually pull. And I've seen it happen before on some cars where it pulls so much that the doors don't even fit anymore. So this is the best way to do that, to avoid the chassis twisting and to make sure you can move it around to get all your tight spots. So now I'm going to bust out the MIG welder and I'm going to fully weld it into the base plates and then start working on some dimple die gussets here and my rear down bars into the base plates. Now the rear is welded into the base plates. I'm actually gonna have to spread this side in the front because it kind of sucked in, so I'm gonna spread it out, push it up against the rocker like it's touching on the other side, and then weld the fronts in. So, I like that this tube kind of lays flat on the base plate, so then I had a little bit more room for a weld, just a little bit more grasp on the base plate always makes me happy. So here's where I ended up with the cage after yesterday. The whole, everything in the cage is welded in. I got the A-pillar dimple die gussets on. They're TIG welded on as well. And then the fitment on the cage was actually so good, I was able to weld it to the A-pillars on both sides. So that's pretty sweet. So yeah, it's got a good weld in there, and then a weld up in there. So the TIG welder actually ran out of argon, so I can't finish the cage right now, and the place isn't open until Monday. But I got my rear two tubes cut that'll come off the main hoop and grab the base plates, and then I'll probably throw a tube in between those as well, just for a little bit of extra strength. But right now, what I'm working on is templating the B-pillar dimple die gussets. So I got my cardboard template here. I'm about to shear up my steel, and I'll transfer that onto the steel, and I'll show you guys how all that goes and what you need. So yeah, they're gonna go right here essentially, and this one's gonna be crazy because it's gonna have to twist pretty hard because the B pillar on the car actually runs forward, and I have the B pillar or the main hoop level in the car, so it's gonna have to be a weird shape, but it's gonna be all right. Got both of them clamped together. You can see there's both of them. I'm gonna use an eighth inch pilot or an eighth inch bit and make a pilot or like an indentation to where the actual hole is gonna go now. Just like that, those are the dimple dissections. I kind of like test fit this one, so I had to bend it a little bit, but yeah, from here you just weld it on. But since I'm out of argon, I can't TIG weld it like I'd like to, so I'm gonna wait. But I'll hold it up so you guys can kind of get an idea of what it's gonna look like. But yeah, basically that's what that's gonna look like. I think it's gonna look pretty damn sick. From the inside, it looks pretty cool too. So I'm going to end this video here. I appreciate you guys watching. If you want to see more like in-depth cage building, like more of what it takes to do this, like pretty much an identical cage I did in Elizabeth's car, go back and look at her build videos on hers. It's just called Elizabeth's Race Car. I think there's like four parts to it. And you know, I talk more about like bending and setup of the machine and stuff like that. So that's why I didn't really go too involved with filming this, because I've already done it and I don't want to make repetitive material. But yeah, hopefully this thing goes to paint in like 2 or 3 weeks. I'm going to try and send it out to get the interior painted first, just so it's out of here for a little while, because I have another big project coming in the beginning of the year, which I'm pretty excited about. I'll touch more on that once it actually gets here. But yeah, thanks again for watching. See you guys next week.